Hey, I thought I'd show you how to make a banding wheel with spare parts from a bicycle and some old wood and screws I got lying around and basically didn't cost me a dime. Here I'm showing you got to cut the spokes off the wheel using a tin snips. You got to cut each one to free up the hub. And that's me showing you what I've already done because I forgot to video it in the beginning. Then you take two pliers and you take off one of the nuts from the hub. So you can slide it out, slide the axle out, and grease it. So there I'm taking it off, and pull a box over, now that I've got it loose, and I spray some WD-40 in it, just to keep the WD-40 off the concrete. And then once it's greased up, obviously if you got axle grease that would be better, but I don't. And you screw it all together, tighten it up right here, use the two pliers again, tighten it up. And you want to make sure that you don't have it too tight so that it binds, but you don't want to have it so loose that it wiggles back and forth inside the hub, the axle. You don't want it wiggling back and forth. So I tighten it up here, and then I back it out a little bit, but I back it out too much. I'll show you the play in it right about here. Right there, you can see. See how it wiggles back and forth? You don't want the axle to slide back and forth in the hub. And then it spins once you tighten it up a bit. Now here, I'm just marking the center of this 2x4 that I've got sitting around by going from corner to corner. And I got a hole saw that is just a little bit bigger than the nut on the end of the axle, because I want to be able to drop that down into the 2x4. So I'm measuring there. Obviously, if you got a drill press, this would be straight up and down. I don't, so I've got a little wiggle room in there. I got to make it a little bit bigger than it needed to be. So here I am marking the depth and drilling down as far as I got. Those are my puppy's paws in the background. She came over to visit. And then I get another hole saw, smaller one, that is the depth of, the thickness of the axle itself, a little bit thicker. So it will fit all the way through, because obviously it protrudes beyond the nut. And I got to go through all the way to the other side. And then you'll see right there, it drops in. Now the axle needs to be centered in that hole to make sure it spins freely. Now here I found four screws that were small enough to go through the little holes that the spokes went through in my little spare box of screws there. I got loose screws that I've accumulated over the years. And I'm marking four of those to make sure it doesn't bind. I take a nail and I just drive a little starter hole in each of my spots. And then I line up the holes again, make sure I'm in a good spot, and I push the screws in, tighten them up a little bit. And now obviously these screws have to be screwed in slightly at an angle because I can't go straight down because of the top part of the hub that is directly above it, so I got to go in slight angle, but that's fine. It's not really going to take a lot of pressure. You're not picking it up and throwing it around. So here I am screwing in the four screws with a flat-bladed screwdriver, which I don't like. I prefer Phillips heads, but the screws I happen to have that fit were flatheads, so here I am tightening them up. Make sure that as you go, before you tighten them all the way down, that your axle still spins inside the hub, that you haven't moved it far enough so that it's actually binding inside the hole that you've drilled into the block. Obviously, if you need a wider base when you're done with this, you can screw that 2x4 into a platform from underneath. And there it is, spins freely, looks good. There's my puppy playing with her hippo, stuffed hippo. Okay, now you grab a board that you want to use for the actual top. And I make sure it's thick enough so that the axle doesn't come through the other side. Draw yourself a circle. Obviously, you can make it as big or as small as you want. And I used a paint can. And I've got a skill saw that is absolute crap. I had an old Black & Decker jigsaw that I loved. And this is a skill, and it broke finally after about 30 years or so. And this one is really crappy. I can't cut a good circle with it. But, you know, after sanding and wiggling around with it, I managed to get it to reasonably round. Not perfectly round, but round enough. Now here I put it on the wheel. I couldn't find the center any other way, so I stuck it on the wheel, on my actual pottery wheel, and I centered it up on there, and I used a Sharpie and went down spiraling toward the center till I finally got one mark, and then I drill a small pilot hole through the middle of it, so I'll know exactly where the middle is, so I can drill my holes to have the hub and the nut come through. Now I'm looking for the right size again. Now these are not going, I need this to sit on top of the nut on this one. Obviously you don't want it to sit on top of the hub itself, or it will not spin. It's got to sit actually on the axle. So it sits on the nut of the axle. So you want to drill a hole in the top that is big enough for the socket wrench to drop down into it, so you can tighten the bolt on the top of the axle. I hope I'm being clear here. So you want to check your depth, and you want to mark it, and you want to make sure that I don't think I checked here to allow for the thickness of the washer that's going underneath, so you'll see that I have to go a little bit deeper. And here's where a drill press would be really helpful, because I'm at a slight angle when I drill this hole, which means there's a slight wobble in the top of the banding wheel when I'm done, and I have to modify the hole slightly to get that to spin flat. But if you've got a drill press, obviously you're working on a flat surface with a bit that is mounted perpendicular. So anyway, here am I. I'm getting it lower and making sure I got it. Now obviously when you do this, you want the entire thing to be countersunk below the surface, otherwise your pot's going to be sitting on the nut. So you got to leave room for the nut and the washer. And then I'm going to go from the underside, and I'm going to make a slot for the nut to fit in, and not go all the way through, because the nut is going to sit on one side of the wood, and the nut of the axle is going to sit on one side, and the nut that goes on the axle is going to sit on the other side. So here I'm just making it slightly bigger, a slightly larger hole with a regular drill bit. Making sure it sits on there. Making sure that it sits down below the level of the actual top of the wood itself. And then I saw that it wasn't quite level, so now I'm going to try to level it out a little bit by angling the drill bit here. That looks pretty good. Now I've got a larger washer that I happen to find sitting in a box of washers, and I'm going to put that on there to give it a little bit more support. Drop the small washer in, and the nut that actually came off the was on the opposite side of the wheel, opposite side of the fork, so you got to save those pieces when you take it off. 9/16 crescent wrench I got there to hold the underside, keep it from spinning. Gets to tight fit, obviously. Got it off, and there it is. Level, not round, but it doesn't matter if it's round. And there you can see I got put a little pot on there just to give it a little test. If you got a bigger pot, you can stick a bat on top and do it that way. And there it is spinning nice and freely. Spins for a long time. It's really loose. Obviously, bicycles are meant to roll. And that one spins a long time. All well and good. The whole thing was basically free if you got the parts laying around. If not, you may have to buy a washer here and there. But the rest of it's pretty much free if you got some wood lying around. Or you can pick it up, scrap. There you go. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Please ask me any questions. Bye.